In this movie, you take a look at various ways to export data from Revit to 3ds Max. If you have Revit installed, start it up and open the provided file named walls.rvt. If you don't have Revit installed, just follow along until it's time you need to interact with 3ds Max. Take a look at the scene. It's a very simple scene with just a few objects, a few walls, doors, and windows. You can orbit around using the view cube or simply using Shift plus middle mouse button. The first rule to follow before you send information from Revit to 3ds Max is that the Revit workspace needs to be in a 3D view. So if you were to temporarily switch to a 2D view, make sure you're back in a 3D view before proceeding. To send data to 3ds Max, you can use one of three methods. If you are using one of the later versions of Autodesk Revit and 3ds Max, you can use a method called Sweep Workflow. It's a very easy process that requires a few simple clicks. You can then choose a template for exterior or interior renderings. When you run the tool, you are prompted for a destination link. This can be a new scene in 3ds Max, an existing scene, or you can choose an active scene if 3ds Max is already running. Data will be updated by default, although there are other options to choose from. When you click on Continue, the information is sent to 3ds Max. Although this method is easy to use, it is not always necessarily the best way to proceed. For one thing, it is only available if you have a recent version of Revit. Also, it is the slowest interaction method between the two applications. More importantly, it translates all Revit components into separate objects in 3ds Max, making them a little hard to manage. You'll notice that every wall, door, and window is a separate object. It's not too bad in a small scene like this, but it can be a hassle in larger scenes. Reset 3ds Max. The other method of importing Revit data into 3ds Max is to link directly to the RVT native format. This can be useful if you need to open a Revit file even if you don't own Revit. In 3ds Max, all you need is to use the import link Revit function to link to the RVT file. This method works well, but still takes a fairly long time to process as 3ds Max needs to translate the Revit data into something it can understand. Attach the file and proceed to dismiss all the dialogs. The third option you will learn about is the one you will adopt for this tutorial. It relies on Fbx interoperability. It's faster than the other methods and is quite convenient when you understand how it operates. Go back to Revit. To export a Revit model to the Fbx file format, first ensure you are in a 3D view. You can then use the Export Fbx feature to give your file a name. Name it mywalls.fbx. If you don't have Revit, a similar file named walls.fbx is already provided. Go back to 3ds Max and use Import again, only this time use the Import Link Fbx method. Choose the walls file, either your own or the one provided to you, and then click Open. The Manage Links dialog appears. Here, you have a choice to combine elements based on your preferred criteria. Leave the Combine by Material option active and attach the file. You are prompted to create a daylight system. Click Yes for now and dismiss the Links dialog when done. This is a small scene, so it does not take very long to load, although it is significantly faster than the other two methods. If you're using 3ds Max or 3ds Max Design 2015, you will see a Scene Explorer to the left-hand side of the screen. This is a new feature in 3ds Max 2015 and makes scene management easier. Normally, this window is docked to the left side of the interface. It's sort of like having a better version of the Select from Scene dialog. Let's take a look at the scene. You chose to combine Revit elements by their materials. This means all objects sharing the same material come in as a single object. In this case, all door panels come in as one object, and all door frames come in as a separate object. All window glass panels have been combined as a single mesh, and the same is true for their frames. The walls are interesting, as they are made of three entities. The reason for that is that the material for the outside of the walls is made of bricks. the inside of gypsum boards, and a third material defines the tops, bottoms, and sides. Combining objects by material makes sense as you can redefine the material and have it update all elements assigned with it. In some cases, you may prefer to combine entities differently. Reset 3ds Max and link to the same FBX file one more time. You may notice an FBM folder that shares the file name. This folder gets expanded to include all media files, such as bitmaps, associated with the scene file. When prompted this time, use the Combine by Category method and attach this file. Dismiss the Daylight System warning and the Link dialog. Here you'll notice two things. First, there is the inevitable annoying little bug that always falls through the cracks. The Scene Explorer gets undocked and moves to the top left corner. This happens every time you link or update an FBX file or a Revit file. You can leave it floating or dock it again, but it will move the next time you link or update the file, as mentioned. It's certainly an annoying little quirk, but nothing that prevents you from doing your work properly. The other thing you'll notice is that combining objects by category simplifies the scene greatly. All walls come in as one object. All doors and all windows are combined likewise. Note that door panels and door frames are all combined as single objects, as the panels and frames are part of the door category. Reset 3ds Max one final time, and this time try the Revit Family Type option. This is somewhat like category, but with a twist. It still combines objects by category, but it also does so by subcategory or family type. In this case, there are two door dimensions of 30 inches wide and 36 inches wide. Although they are part of the same category, they are of distinct family types, and they are combined accordingly. The wider doors come in as one object, and the narrower doors as a separate object. The same thing holds true for the two types of windows involved. Any one of these three methods of combining objects work well. I personally favor the family type method, but you might feel differently as you develop your own workflows. Try not to use the combine as one object or the do not combine methods, as I find that they make scene management harder than it needs to be. Of course, whether you use Suite Workflow or link to an RVT or FBX file, you keep a live link active between Revit and 3ds Max. This means you can go back to Revit and make a design change, and export back to the same FBX file you saved earlier. In 3ds Max, you can check for changes by using References, Manage Links to get back to the Links dialog after closing it. In the Files tab, a red flag indicates that the linked file has changed, and you can then reload it. Sure enough, you have new bigger windows on the walls, and since they're on a separate family type, they come in as one object. With these basic principles explained, it is time to move to a more complex, more complete architectural design. This is what you do in the next movie.